a place that I love as well as my Virgie home 'neath the maiden tree hill. My Virgie home, that haven of mine, the home of my parents, so loving and kind. I love them so, and I always will. And my Virgie home 'neath the maiden. Birds and robins, their sweet notes entwine. The fishing boats shiny and the water so still. Here in my home, 'neath the maiden tea hill. When I had trouble or if I was sad, I always found comfort from good friends I had. They knew that I loved them and I always will. And my bird.
Good evening. Welcome to This Week in Review. Tonight's stories include highlights from Canada Day, a view from Signal Hill, St. John's, a tour of VOCM Radio, an update from the Burgio Museum, some activities planned for the Sand and Sea Festival, and more, so please stay tuned.
They're not hip or modern, fancy or fashionable. They no longer fit your prescription or your style. But for one person living in a developing country, these used eyeglasses will put the world in focus, maybe for the very first time. Don't throw away someone's chance for a clearer tomorrow. Donate your used eyeglasses.
Unlike last year, the weather was a little more cooperative on July 1st, and the Canada Day activities went ahead as scheduled. The festivities got underway with a parade from the Town Hall parking lot to Sandbanks Provincial Park for a day of fun and games. Canada flags and pins, as well as Canada Day balloons, were given out at the Town Hall parking lot and at the park. BG, the Burgio Gull, was on hand to help with the distribution of these items. Various activities were held for kids and adults to participate in at the park, and music for the day was provided by Nick's Disco. Burger and Pop was provided for everyone at the Burgio Recreation Commission from 4 to 5. With a display of fireworks on the beach. Set.
Nice, to come backwards.
The Burgio Volunteer Fire Department have replaced their fire van. The old van, a 1977, was given to the fire department by the Lions Club after being used for a number of years as the town's ambulance. The fire department has had their new van for approximately 3 months. The dog and other designs on the sides and back of the van were painted by Kay Kosser, and the lettering was done at Trimline. This van is used in rescue and gear such as breathing apparatuses to fire scenes. The fire department had to use their new van early Friday morning when they were called to the scene of a house fire in the Messers area. The Burgio Volunteer Fire Department responded to a fire call at the residence of Bruce Clojer at 3:15 a.m. on Friday morning. Fire Chief John Durnford informed me that the fire department arrived at the scene in 5 to 6 minutes of the call to find the house completely engulfed in flames. The major flames were extinguished in about 3 minutes, said Chief Durnford, but the crew remained on the scene for about 1.5 hours extinguishing hot spots. Chief Durnford informed me that it was an accidental fire and no one was injured in the blaze. The Burgio Museum Tourist Chalet opened for this tourist season 2 weeks ago. We visited the museum this past week to see if there are any additions to the artifacts already on display. We're here at the Burgio Tourist Chalet Museum, and we're speaking with Clinton Barter, who's one of the workers here for this summer. Clinton, how many students are working here this summer?
Well, there are 4 students who work on a regular basis, Dave, and 2 more which come in every second weekend to just work the weekend, sort of give us a break.
Okay, so what hours is the building open?
The building is open from 10 a.m. to 8 p.m. Monday to Friday, and on Saturdays and Sundays it's open from noon to 8 p.m.
Okay, have you had many visitors so far this season?
Well, within the first 2 weeks now, we've had 49 who have actually signed the guest book, and of course there are numerous ones who come in and out and don't take heed to signing the guest book or don't feel like signing it or whatever. But I'd say we've seen close to 60 or 70 people so far.
Okay, do you have any new artifacts on display here this year?
Yes, actually there's 4 new ones brought in recently. There was a model of a side trawler brought in by Dave Calder, a RCA battery-operated radio brought in by Brad Green, and a reading book, school book brought in by Brad Green, and a hold-hand wringer washer brought in by Brad Green.
Okay, Clinton, there are quite a number of artifacts on display here. Do you know exactly how many there are?
There are close to a little over 200 right now, I believe. A lot of them are tiny, so they don't take up much room.
Okay, have you noticed any particular item that seems to grab most people's attention?
Well, some of the ones that grab most people's attention would be the old sled, the Bob Runner. And the handmade bureau, which is made by a woman close to around 100 years ago. Mr. Calder's model boat. The old dentist chair that came from the old cottage hospital. They're in some of the most popular ones that people seem to be sort of shocked or surprised when they see it.
Okay, Clinton, is there anything else that you'd like to add?
Well, if anyone has any crafts or articles that they'd like to bring in the museum to put on display, permanent or temporary, we will be more than glad to put them out on display for you. All you have to do is just bring them into the museum any day between 10 in the morning and 8 in the night, or on Saturdays between noon and 8 p.m.
Okay, Clinton, well, we'd like to thank you for speaking with us, and we'll let you get back to work.
All right, thank you very much, Dave.
Stay tuned for more of This Week in Review coming up after this message.
Welcome to Label Smart, our nutrition labeling quiz. Our guests for today are Mr. Baxter and Mr. Franklin. When it comes to dietary fats, moderation is the way to go. Now, tell me, many foods claim that they are reduced in fat. Can you trust that these claims are true?
I don't trust anything these days.
These claims are true. When a claim about fat is made, the label must give a lot of information.
Excellent. This label shows us that this fat-reduced sausage contains 4 grams of fat in a serving. How much is that?
The same amount of fat as in 1 teaspoon of butter or margarine, in a serving of 3 slices.
Oh, that's easy.
To be label smart is really easy, and choosing lower fat foods more often is the key to healthy eating.
What about a higher fat choice once in a while?
No problem. Don't sell your barbecue.
The smart eater is label smart. A message from the National Institute of Nutrition.
As most of you are aware, I was on vacation last week. During that time, I had a chance to visit Signal Hill in St. John's for a look at the fort as well as the view of the city.
Hotter than a hoochie-coochie. We laid rubber on the Georgia asphalt. We got a little crazy, but we never got caught. Down by the river on a Friday night, hearing little cans in the pale moonlight. Talking about cars and dreaming about women. Never had a plan, just a living for the minute. Yeah, way down yonder on the Chattahoochee. Never knew how much that muddy water meant to me. But I learned how to swim and I learned who I was. A lot about living and a little about love. Well, we fogged up the windows in my old Chevy. I was willing, but she wasn't ready. So I settled for a burger and a grape snow cone. I dropped her off early, but I didn't go home. Down by the river on a Friday night, pyramid of cans in the pale moonlight. Talking about cars and dreaming about women. Never had a plan, just a living for the minute. Yeah, went down yonder on the Chattahoochee. Never knew how much of muddy water meant to me. But I learned how to swim and I learned who I was. A lot about living and a little about love. Chattahoochee, never knew how much that muddy water meant to me. But I learned how to swim and I learned who I was. A lot about living and a little about love. A lot about living and a little about love.
That's a special way of life.
Down home, where they know you by name and treat you like family. Down home, a man's good word and a handshake are all you need. Folks know, if they're falling on hard times, they can fall back on.
In the corner of the hardware store, gathered round a checkerboard, old men telling lies and crowning kings. Kids driving round the old town square, cops roll down in the cool night air, go and see what's shaking at the Dairy Queen.
down home, where they know you by name and treat you like family. Down home, a man's good word and a handshake are all you need. Folks know if they're falling on hard times, they can fall back home. Those of us raised up down. When I was born, I couldn't wait to leave this place. But now I want to see my children raised down home. Down home. Folks know if they're falling on hard times, they can fall back. Falling on hard times, they can fall back on. Those of us raised up down home, down home, way down home, down.
We spotted the ocean at the head of the trail. Where are we going? So far away. Somebody told me this is the place where everything's better. Don't even have pictures, just memories to hold. Grow sweeter each season as we slowly grow.
Also during my trip to St. John's, I had the opportunity to tour VOCM with Dick Greaves. I took my camera along on the tour to show you where VOCM originates.
VOCM newsroom, and this is our state-of-the-art news delivery program facility. The gentleman you're looking at right there is Doug Learning. Have you got him all in the picture there?
Yep.
That's Dougie. Anyway, just can we move up a little bit, because we've got some people going to sneak behind us here. What Doug is doing is taking our news, taking some news that's coming in off the wire services. But as you look out there, if you pan up a little bit and look outside, you'll see two satellite dishes out through the front windows of VOCM, and actually you'll see three. Those three satellite dishes are downlink and uplink capability to various satellites. We have, right now we're shooting two dishes to one satellite, and we have a third dish on another one. But that also allows us to not only send, but pull down signals from various other news medium. We take news from broadcast news, and of course from CNN in Atlanta. We take it off the big satellite up there, 24,000 miles in space. And pretty state-of-the-art. This gentleman here, down in front of us, is Vince Gallant. Vince does our morning news here on VOCM. And as you can see, Vince is at a computer terminal. Our complete newsroom is automated, and everything is on computer. Our voices are all done digitally. It's all done digital recording, and so that we don't have any tapes or cassettes to play. We just pick up the line we want on the computer. I can highlight that if I want to use it, push the button, and it voices. That's the VOCM newsroom. And of course, VOCM is noted for its extensive news coverage. That's where it all happens, of course, at this particular station. And our station here also feeds the other stations in the VOCM network. We're going down one of our hallways here at VOCM. This is towards the sales office. There's Shelley. Shelley's one of our sales secretary. Ross Hillier here. That's right. And this one here is our sales in the office. They keep track of the commercials as they come into the station, and that's where all the billing is done from. And sales manager over here, this is Dave Broomfield. Dave looks after all the sales here at VOCM. Basically, he holds the light, and we chop the wood. That's the way that works in sales. Continuing our little tour down the hall here at VOCM, we have sales offices here at VOCM where our sales men and women work from. Various offices. What you're going to see now is some of the management team where they work from. You'll notice there's nobody in their office. What's new? These guys are either playing golf, playing tennis, doing something. We're here working. They're out having a good time. That's one of the advantages of being the boss. Okay. This is the office of our program director. Notice he's missing. But yet we do have stuff on the air, okay? There's where he would be if he showed up for work today. Now come on over here. The door is closed on the operations manager's office. Let's get his name, Jay Murphy. John Murphy didn't even show up for work. Actually, he's taking a day's holiday. But even when he's here, he doesn't work, okay? I'm the only one that works here. You know, we got a couple. Jane works, my morning team, but that's it. Okay, over here, come on, I'll show you something. Down this hallway, big building. This is our continuity department where they write commercials for the radio. Come on down, take a look. This is Jane. Come here, Jane.
Hi, everybody.
This is Jane Haynes. This is Jane. Now, Jane does the traffic on the morning show. And that's right. You people in Virgio. This is for Virgio Broadcasting.
Oh, hi, everybody.
All right, there you go. And don't turn your TV off. Don't try to adjust it. It won't look any better. Okay,
no, trust me, it won't.
This is Jane.
This is as good as it gets.
All right. So come on down. I'll show you continuity. This is our continuity department in here. This is where they write commercials. And these are our creative people. Notice they are real people, and they do show up for work here on occasion. And that's about it. There are no royalties here.
No, don't show me.
Okay. Anyway, we'll go back over next door. Now, over here, we have our music library.
What are you doing?
And this is our music library, and this is Jane stealing music. Actually, Jane,
don't tell anybody,
what are you doing with this stuff?
Giveaways.
Oh, sure, Jane, sure. You can pick those up at Jane's house any day. This is our music library. Now, behind these big cabinets, and in all of these cabinets that you'll see on the other side here, We have between 5,000 and 10,000 CDs, and that's our music system. And of course, we don't play records. There are no records at VOCM anymore. The oldies, the real old stuff, is on record, Frank Sinatra and that stuff, but we don't play much of that anymore. I don't think I've played it ever. But anyway, that's our music library. This is one of my favorite rooms here, next to the men's room. This is our little kitchen area. And as you can see, we have the means for survival. If we get another blizzard like we had, we can stay alive for about a week based on what's in there. And we have a sink and a refrigerator, and we have the coffee machine. Now, you want to see something that'll blow you away? You probably thought, Dick Reeves, nobody. Let me show you something. Look at here. Got my own office. R. Reeves. Now, that stands for Richard, okay? But they actually let me have my own office back in here. It's a pretty stark place. Let me even turn the light on. I even have electricity. And this is my office here at VOCM. This is where I work, my little cell, or compound, if you will. Computer terminal, telephone, paper, because I doodle a lot. And there we are. Now, we'll go out here, and through this door is engineering, the engineering department at VOCM. Now, another one of our management people would be the chief engineer, okay? Notice, empty seat. But I tell you, these people don't work. We do the work. These guys, nothing. Okay, it's the law in Canada and the United States too that we keep a record, a 24-hour record of all programming that goes on the air. This particular tape system here, if you notice, they're moving real slow. That's because we need one tape to keep a 24-hour record. So it takes 24 hours for those to run out. We're also picking up recording VOCM, our station in Carbonear, CHVO. We're recording CKVO in Clarenville, and VOFM, our FM station. Now down this way, I'll show you something else. Pepsi and Coke. You need it to live, okay? Now, this is one of our engineers here. This is Brian Matthews, and you notice, what is Brian doing here? Look, what I tell you about management, they're either not here or they're playing video games. And Brian is doing video games right now at VOCM. You know how much we pay him to do this? Unbelievable amounts of money. Okay, now you're gonna see a reflection here. There's Dave Cooper's reflection. There's my reflection. There's Dave waving. Dave was here at VOCM today. And that's our test center. This gives us an idea whether or not the plug is still in the wall. That's what, something like that. I'm not sure what that thing does, but it looks pretty confusing. Okay, up this way, we have another, now you might have to get close for this, but this is another one of our, part of our test center. And we have our various monitors in here, okay? And basically, that's it. The only thing we didn't show you that we're pretty proud of is the fact that we have indoor plumbing here at VOCM. We have indoor toilets that flush and sinks where the water comes out of, and it's hot and cold running. It's an amazing place to work, fun place. Okay, now the next time when we come back, we're gonna show you the studio at VOCM where I get to play and have fun. And you're gonna say, they pay him to do that? And not much, but you'll see that when we come back. Okay, we're in the studio at VOCM now. This is the main studio of 590 VOCM in St. John's, where you listen, where what you hear on the Virgil Broadcasting System comes through this studio you're seeing right now. This is our main control area here at VOCM, and if you want to take a look down here, this is our control board. This is a series, these are sliding, like, you know, on your TV, you have a knob you turn right or left, or a button you push to get your volume. With ours here, we just push these up or down, up for more volume, down for no volume. And what I'm gonna do right now is put my next song on, and we'll show you how we do that. And we're gonna push this button, and we're gonna push that button. And we're gonna do it like this.
Today's hits, yesterday's favorites. $1 million music.
They just paid me to do that. Push a button. Oh, geez, I can't believe it. And people say, why do you do this for a living? Anyway, this is our control board. Obviously our microphone system, and we have a video computer terminal here. This computer terminal is what we were talking about when we showed you the newsroom. I can access all kinds of information on that terminal. As it is now, very shortly, I'm going to be putting a weather forecast on there. I'm taking the weather forecast from the National Weather Service. I'm going to retype it to suit my presentation style, and each announcer would do that same thing respectively as well. The telephone system that we have here, I'll just show this to you real quick. We have a telephone system here that's pretty interesting. It's called a Telenox system. And as you see, there's no buttons. Everything is all touch control. And this system allows us to take calls, conference calls, send calls. If the lines are busy, it'll tell us that we have a call coming in, and we'll tell us how many seconds we have to answer it. We do all of our control work for the phones from the Telenox system. Looking up above, we have our monitor panel. Our first screen, which is pretty dark right now, you may be seeing it roll a little bit, but our first screen up there is a picture of our FM production studio. And we have that up there so that if in case of an emergency, we could do news from up there or whatever, interviews, and we could be able to see the person who's doing the presentation. The next screen you see is the VOCMI in the sky. And I'll just move that for you. I have a remote control here I'll show you in a second. But anyway, basically I can move that. You'll see it move up and down. I can zoom in. Let's take a look at, like, say, Signal Hill. We're looking east. There's the Narrows. Now let's take a look at Signal Hill. There comes Signal Hill into view. That has a 16:1 zoom ratio. We can zoom in on traffic. If we see an accident, we can take a look at it by pushing in. Like, let's watch that car right there. There we go. There's a truck moving down 10 Mile Road here in St. John's today. And that's the way things are. Our next screen is our color weather radar. And I'm going to put that on for you now. That gives us an image of cloud conditions and the Avalon and what have you. Now I just push the button. That gives me a view of what's happening at 30 kilometers. And that tells me right now that there's no precipitation out there. That would be green. The next screen is my internal terminal. And that lets me see what's going on in and around the studio this morning. And they also, that goes elsewhere in the building so that they can see what's going on in AM control, where we are right now. Anyway, that's what's happening there. Now, I'm going to change tunes again here. I've got to change songs. I've got to say hi to the folks, so bear with me for one moment, and we'll show you how we do our announcing. Just a brief example. It's 11:12 at VOCM, and gee, it is such a nice day out there today. I know, it's summertime here in Newfoundland, and the temperature's today near 30, and you know what? More of the same tomorrow. We ought to keep this one for posterity, I'll tell you. So that's a little tour of the VOCM AM studio, and we hope you folks in Virgil have enjoyed it. And next time you're in town visiting, why don't you stop in person and let us show you around ourselves and see it firsthand. Nice to see you today.
The Sand and Sea Festival is fast approaching, and the final plans are being made. Here are a few of the many activities that are planned for the festival. Sand and Sea Festival will get underway with opening ceremonies at Sandbanks Provincial Park at 2 p.m. on August 4th, with many activities to follow that afternoon, including a kite flying contest, a water balloon toss, mussel boil, just to name a few. Also, local entertainers will be on hand. Other activities throughout the week will include a Lions Mini Fair, bingos, a Newfie Night, horseshoe tournament, potluck supper, dart tournaments, a flea market, a fun day at the park, a teddy bear picnic, a burger takeout, canoe races, sandcastle contests, dances, adult, preteen, teenage, and seniors, and a lot more activities. Agendas for the festival are available at the local tourist chalet museum. Well, that's it for this week. Thanks for watching. For This Week in Review, I'm Dave Cooper. Good night.